So are you enjoying this session? You are? Okay. So I'm not going to have a conversation with Nandita because Nandita is going to have a conversation with you. Just a very informal introduction of Nandita. Nandita is a dear friend, although almost a decade younger than I am. It's an extremely inspiring story that Nandita has to tell. And I think she's one of my inspirations. And I thought that, you know, she should really speak to all of you. Just a short, two things that I would like to tell you is, when I heard Nandita's story when she was 24, she suffered from TB. And on one day, she just lost her hearing. Like, just like that. And life changed for Nandita. Nandita is a journalist with Economic Times. It's not that, you know, these things have ever deterred her from really working. But after what she's gone through, and she just had a cochlear implant done, which means she can now hear, some parts of what we are saying through a mechanism that is, you know, fitted here, right? Yes. And she has taken this challenge into, you know, she's made it her strength. And she's one of the young disability activists for youngsters. One thing that Nandita, I read one of her posts, and you know, one of her posts actually said that, you know, you enjoyed the movie, but where were the subtitles? I mean, we never think of these things, right? When we go for a movie, we never think of someone who might not be able to hear and how he can enjoy something. So is entertainment not meant for young who are disabled? These are certain questions that I think Nandita has been raising. And over to her, enough of me.
Thank you, Saili, for this very lovely introduction. And I'm going to be speaking on a very unusual topic that is generally not spoken about at such conferences. And that is about youth and disabilities. Let me start with a small incident that happened to me. It was a hot, sunny afternoon in March 2016. And I entered the Thane railway station for a long commute to work to CST, where my office is situated. And it felt like just any other day. But when I entered the station, I was in for a rude shock. Right in the railway bridge, none, and I mean to say none of the indicators were working. What did it mean for me? As a hearing impaired individual, I'm solely reliant on these indicators, the red indicators that you see, because I cannot hear to the announcements. None of the indicators were working, and taking in the apathy from unhelpful people at the railway station, I felt as helpless as I could, and I did not know what to do after that. Facing this, it was a huge inconvenience for me, and I also went late, and I was delayed for work. This apathy and ignominy and the helplessness that I faced summarizes more or less what every person with disability, a youngster like me, faces in India or everywhere on a daily basis. Let me go back to now, November 22nd, 2013. 2 days after I had celebrated my 24th birthday, I woke up from a mere 10-minute afternoon nap from 2 o'clock to 2:10 to pin drop silence. I woke up becoming deaf. Now, minutes before, I could hear everything, and just 10 minutes later, I stared at a silent world. I had attended college, Ruya College, like all of you. I had spent 23 years of my life listening to everyone. And 2 days after my 24th birthday, I became deaf. What was the reason for this? It was an anti-tuberculosis injection that was given to me. I'm a two-time intestinal TB survivor, and I also fought a very long, 8-year-long battle that started at the age of 17. It was a long and a traumatic battle against TB and after that disability that I had to fight. It left a lot of scars in me, my hopes and my aspirations for my future dwindled. Up until that point in my life, I had never really given a thought about disability, never. I was a young, free-spirited, college-going girl with, you know, who gives a thought about such issues? We rarely see such issues anywhere. But isn't this true for, you know, all of us sitting over here? As youngsters, we take most of the things that we have for granted. And therefore, we have very little idea about what the challenges that persons with disabilities like me face on a daily basis. Because I can tell you this because I spent 23 years just like all of you, and on bang in the middle of my life, things changed for me. And I was declared 90% deaf. I have to say this, that once I started reading up about disability issues so that I could also get back to normalcy, I realized that apart from the general societal apathy that does exist in many parts of India, I also realized that policymakers in India also give very little importance, you know, precious little, for issues that concern us. Let me take a simple example, that the interim budget that was presented last week made no mention of persons with disabilities. Isn't this a matter of grave concern and shame that an interim budget with elections coming up made no mention of persons with disabilities despite giving a 2-hour long speech by the finance minister? Moreover, the fact is that persons with disabilities constitute over 2.2% of the population in India, which includes me and several other youngsters like us. But the union budget allocation over the years has almost remained stagnant at 0.1% or lower. The proportion is extremely disproportionate, that when Indians, 2.2% of Indians face some form of disability, it could be, the gravity could be different, it could be as grave as mine or it could be even lesser, but union budget allocations have almost remained stagnant over the years at 0.1% or lower. This, according to me, defines the apathy that happens at a policymaker's level, because it to me shows that, you know, people like us are not considered vote banks by many of the political parties. It is important that persons with disabilities are not considered some form of a liability or charity for people to come and show their care, but they should be seen as active agents for participating in the country's development. I am an educated girl. I have the desire to do well. But what is stopping me is probably not that it's a fault in me, but it is the fact that there are issues out there for me that are not addressed. Let me tell you some of the things that, after speaking to several other people, persons with disabilities, I want to tell you what can be done. Ideally, I hope Milind Deora and Poonam Mahajan should have been there to listen this, but I would like to tell all of you, because this is something that concerns each one of you. We are also part of the society, and we also need to know that things could change. You don't need to have grand revamps and big words. It is small, small things that are done on a daily basis and small, small tweaks where changes can happen. Simple. First, let us take the physical infrastructure that is there. Physical infrastructure is hardly accessible to the disabled. How many places do we see, whether it is toilets, whether it is colleges, whether it is hospitals, that are accessible, wheelchair accessible, for example? Very few. It is only now, even when I studied in college, I remember that it was much later, towards my fag end of my stint at Ruya, that they introduced the ramps for wheelchair accessibility. Until that, my college was not wheelchair accessible for a long time. let me tell you, this has been a long-standing demand of the deaf community that we should start having subtitles in movies. In the last 5 years, let me tell you, I haven't watched a single movie in the theater. Not because I don't want to watch the movie. I'm a big, big Bollywood buff. I love movies. I thrive on movies. I love actors and actresses just like everyone sitting over here. The simple reason I have not watched a movie in theater is simply because there are no subtitles. This has been a long-standing demand from us that we need to have subtitles so that people like me can go and watch the movie. Why should I be denied of my entertainment opportunities simply because someone else, producers don't want to put in subtitles, or there has not been sufficient pressure from the government to the film industry to put subtitles? Why not? It is important that things, small things like these, can lead to bigger changes and become more accessible for me. Second, I want to say that there has been another demand that the Indian Sign Language should be included among the national languages in the country. There is a petition happening in the Delhi High Court, which I think should definitely be acted upon, because it means that governments and colleges and every other public places, sign language will become an important, will have to be instituted so that persons who can't hear will be able to communicate. Next, I'm sure if all of you who would be tracking news would have heard in 2017, when the goods and services tax was introduced, there was an uproar over the fact that assistive aids, what do you mean by assistive aids? These aids that I'm wearing, or let's say braille for the blind, or say hearing aids for the deaf, they were taxed with almost 18% GST. This is akin to taxing my right to basic right to walk and to hear. It is after uproar that it was finally brought down to 5%. But is this should this tax even exist? No, should not. What is the reason? Because you are taxing my basic right to walk. If I remove these aids right now, I won't be able to hear anything. If you are going to add even a 5% tax on this, this is going to become unaffordable for me. Mind you, these implants that I'm wearing are cost over 20 lakhs. It is not something that I paid for. I fortunately got funding for this. 4 funders came together and they brought me these implants. If you're going to add GST to this, this is going to become unaffordable for everyone who needs it. What is the point? These assistive aids are what help us move ahead in life. This is assistive aids are what is needed so that I enjoy the mobility in society just like everyone else. 5% GST should not be there ideally, because before the pre-GST era, none of these had any customs or anything. They were all waived off. Because as I said, this is akin to, you know, taxing my right to hear. This should not happen. You know, these aids are what is helping me hear right now and to follow some bit of what is happening. And thirdly, I wanted to say that apart from these basic levels, it is also important that each one of us here institute some change. Let's say in your colleges, I'm sure you would have some persons with disabilities. Show your compassion, be empathetic, show them and treat them as equal. Be empathetic towards them. They are also like every one of us sitting over here. We also have the drive to do everything. And I want to end my speech today saying here, this is the line I said during my speech at the United Nations General Assembly that I gave in September, that I may not hear you today, but I'll make sure you hear me loud and clear.
How was that, huh?